Hello and welcome, Dragon Riders. I am as Kalamos. This is Century Age of Ashes, a free-to-play multiplayer dragon battle game. Age of Ashes is releasing December 2nd this year to PC and consoles and mobile next year, 2022. Take on the skies as a fearsome marauder, a relentless hunter riding upon the blood chaser dragon. Protect your allies as the shielding wingard riding on the ironwing dragon. Tactical and as stealthy as a rogue, the Phantom rides on the mysterious Night Snagger Dragon. With the introduction to the game out of the way, let's get into the information you're all here for. Remember that all of the topics I will go over are subject to change and removal by Playwing as they see fit. Some of these topics were only barely shown during live streams, so for some, we don't have the full picture yet. Today I'm going to go over the changes from the second closed beta, what we have to expect from the launch of Season 0 this Thursday, December 2nd, and what the future of Century will look like. So what has improved or changed since the second beta? Though we were promised to have our progress saved from the beta to the launch, the number of changes made to Century since then has made it impossible to transfer over the data. We are instead being compensated with a loot chest depending on the level we reached in the second beta. We are still getting the beta phantom skin, Arid Ritual, if you had claimed it during the second beta. The overview feature has now changed locations to a cliff settled in some mountains, way more beautiful in my opinion. An improvement asked for by the community was a change to the leveling system. The amount of experience needed to reach new levels after level 30 in the second beta rose exponentially, with a total time needed to reach max level ranging from 2900 hours of playtime to 6400 hours. Translated into days, that is between 120 days and 165 days of playtime. At launch, the leveling system should feel way better. It is no longer as drastic and should be more enjoyable. Almost hand in hand with leveling comes the mission system. Daily and weekly quests should no longer be as hard as they were in the beta, nor as specific. They should now be doable by anyone. In the beta, the map Aldrin Sanctuary was played more like a Microsoft PowerPoint than an actual game. The performance in this map and overall in Century should be much better than it was in the second beta. Mouse and keyboard sensitivity has been changed as well, so you no longer have to have it set up to the max DPI with the whole desk just to move around effectively. Controls overall are going to be better for when Century launches. We have word that there will be no in-game voice chat or text chat to discourage toxicity. There's also an anti-cheat system to prevent, you guessed it, cheaters. Now for what most of you want to hear, MMR and ranked. Your MMR is now dependent on whether or not you win or lose a match. As long as you win, your MMR will rise. Ranked will also be at launch for currently only Spoils of War, that could change in the future. There will also be casual queues for each mode, Spoils, Carnage, and Gates as well. Arena seems generally unchanged with the Skirmish mode. What are some new features added since the second beta? There's now a new game mode called Spoils of War where you go out battling enemies for whoever can collect the most gold. This is being played on the new map, Yarlantir Harbor. Carnage and Gates of Fire modes will also be available on the Harbor map. Collect gold for your coffer, steal gold from your enemies, and use special event items such as the jewel and the bomb to your advantage to win. Are you a lore fanatic? Do you want to know the background of every dragon in the game? Well, there's a feature for that. Is a Bestiary, and it keeps track of the skins you see in the shop and the ones you own. Learn the lore for the dragons you have as you explore the world of Century. The Bestiary is still in development and may change in the future. Dragon hatching. Ever wanted to see some cute baby dragons? Well, now Century has them. No longer eggs just an afterthought when playing matches. Now you have to do missions to grow your egg to a baby, then an adult. No teenage dragons, sadly. No edgy dragons. The rarer a dragon egg is, the harder the missions you need to complete become to grow it. Sadly, we can't pet the baby dragons, or any dragons for that matter, but that may be a thing of the future. What about the game modes? A mode cited during the betas was one called Survival, where it is a 6v6v6 battle to which if you die, an ally would have to pick you up and bring you back to your base to be able to revive you. This mode was put on the backlog because of the introduction of the Spoils of War mode. For Spoils of War, we have word that the gold in the map expires after a short while, so you must pick it up and drop it in your coffers before it disappears. The health pickup and spoils are currently exclusive to that game mode as well, but I wouldn't mind it in another mode like Gates of Fire. Both Carnage and Gates of Fire modes are generally unchanged since the second beta, with the only addition being that they can now be played on the Harbor map. If you wish to train in the free flight mode, Hunabotan Lake is the only map available to train in. I bet in the future we will be able to train in as well on Sanctuary and Harbor, but is not yet available at launch. There is also no spectator mode to view friends' matches, but could be a thing of the future. Now for what you all want to hear about, the dragons. Some general changes to the balancing of the dragons include a health change. In the beta, all three dragons had the same health pool of 100 HP. Now for launch, Phantom will have 75 HP, Windguard will have 100 HP, and Marauder will have 125 HP. This makes them feel more attuned to their class feel, mainly Phantom feeling more roguelike and susceptible to damage, and Marauder feeling tankier. All classes now have to shoot 2 fireballs instead of 3 from the betas. There is no 4th class for launch, but more about that later. One major class change comes in the form of a slight nerf to the mine ability Phantom has. The mines are now easier to see, but to make up for it, they now have 2 charges. Windguard and Marauder's abilities are generally unchanged. There's a new mechanic for when you fall too low health. It is called Rage. You gain Rage as you take damage. Once you have gained enough Rage, if you activate your main power, you gain access to an improved version of that power with even greater damage and shielding. The improved versions of the powers are as follows. Marauder's Rage, Hunter's Fury, gives Hunter's Mark to all enemies and refreshes the duration of the mark on elimination. Phantom's Rage, Mortal Shroud, improves Mystic Shroud, allowing you to become invisible and untargetable, and allows you to fire infinite fireballs that deal increased damage while you are in Rage. Wingard's Rage, Exhalation Surge, enhances Salvation Surge. When you use it on an ally, they are shielded and gain Berserk, and both dragons are fully healed. There is a possibility that Rage has been tweaked in each game mode to feel slower or faster depending on the mode. Passives have been added to each class. Marauder's passive is Relentless Predator. When you kill or participate in a kill, all of your cooldowns reset. Phantom's passive is Guard Shatterer. You deal more damage to enemy shields. And last but not least, Wingard's passive is Skeldian Resolve. You are less affected by shockwaves and negative status effects have a shorter duration. What does the future of Sentry Age of Ashes look like? New game modes, classes, and events will be a thing of the future. Depending on community feedback, things such as a clan system and battle pass could also probably happen. A recent interview with Playwing developers gives us plenty of information about what we have to look forward to in Sentry. Let's have a look. Our launch also marks the debut of what we call Season Zero, with a rolling roadmap of live events and updates. Every month, players will have the opportunity to take part in 2 main events, each with their own set of rules and themed rewards. No spoilers, but let's just say you'll find a mix of modes you've seen elsewhere, with their own twist and more unique, refreshing ideas. These events will also serve as testbeds for potential permanent features, and will be key to launch of our competitive Season 1 later in 2022. On top of live events, we will roll out regular tentpole updates to introduce core features to the game. For example, we're working on a 4th rider class and dragon species, new maps, and a PvE mode. We can't put a date on these updates yet, and there will be plenty more to come, so keep your eyes peeled. Sentry Age of Ashes has been in development since 2017, so we are rest assured we have quite a few ideas in our bag. I can't wait to hear about the events and themed cosmetics. This will start shortly after the launch of the game, as earlier in the interview it stated that it'll start in December 2021 with a festive event revolving around a limited time game mode and special customizations. More details to come soon. We should be hearing more about these events in the following weeks. Winter-themed dragon skins will be really amazing. One thing I've been looking forward to hearing more about are partnerships. It was hinted at in an earlier livestream that streamer or content creator partnerships with Sentry Age of Ashes will be coming. It was said in the article that, to the addition of customizations earned through the game by leveling and the shop, they will also be obtained in weekly or monthly live events, special activations, or partnerships. Spoilers. We already know that some of the live events are going to be in the form of the 2 main events happening each month. I predict that we will be possibly getting promotional codes for dragon skins, dragon armors, rider armors, or weapons by content creators to promote the launch of Sentry. As of the making of this video, we have no word on this yet. And that seems to be about everything we know or can guess about the future and launch of Sentry Age of Ashes. I hope you all enjoyed the Sentry deep dive. As we get more information, I hope to provide that to you in a video form much like this one. By the end of the year, I hope to reach 50 subscribers, so if you feel up for it, go ahead and support me by doing so. Catch me live at twitch.tv/ezkalamos, for I will be streaming Sentry on launch day. Thank you all for watching, and see you next time.